In this video, you will see what errors you might get when playing your recorded scripts and how to troubleshoot them. Let's record a simple workflow. We will open Chrome browser, navigate to gmail.com, and create a new message. Now, let's play the recorded workflow. As you can see, we have an error on step Switch to Window as the title of the window, particularly the number of unread emails, has changed since the recording. We need to edit this action in the script. One way you can do it is to refresh the list of available windows and select the new window from the dropdown. However, it is not a sustainable solution in our case. If the number of unread emails changes in the future, the execution will fail again. A more reliable way is to select option Enter Window Title or Part of Title and enter a unique part of the window title, by which the bot will be able to find it. In this case, the email address. Let's play the recording once again. The Switch to Window action is executed successfully. However, the bot fails on the next step, mouse click. In recording mode, window controls are recorded as the default option for mouse actions. However, they will not work inside web pages that are not a part of Windows applications. We will need to edit these mouse actions to make them work in a browser. To do it, we need to switch the target mode to image. Images are recorded as a fallback option for all mouse actions. The position of the click is captured during recording, too. We need to edit the second mouse click, too. Here, we need to capture a new image. Click on the image to edit the anchor image, and click Position to ensure the execution is always successful. When recording user actions, RPA Recorder records the delays before certain actions. Having delay before executing some actions are necessary for error-free execution. Let's delete the recorded delay in this mouse click action and see what happens when we play the script. As you can see, the mouse click fails as the window with the image, on which the bot needs to click, is not loaded yet. So a delay before executing this action is required. Instead of setting an explicit delay, we can set a timeout for the action. Let's set a timeout of 10,000 milliseconds and a polling interval of 300 milliseconds. So the bot will try to find the image and click on it every 300 milliseconds for up to 10 seconds. Now, let's play the final script. As you can see, the bot successfully executes all actions and sends an email.